Your healthcare provider has ordered lung volume recruitment, also called breath stacking. Breath stacking expands your child's lungs and may improve their ability to cough, speak, and eat. It may also help move secretions and lower the risk of illness. To give a treatment, start by cleaning your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Gather the equipment and supplies you need, a manual resuscitation bag, a piece of extension tubing if needed, an adapter if needed, non-sterile gloves if you want to wear gloves, a patient interface such as a mouthpiece, face mask, or trach tube adapter, and a nose clip if needed. For this video, we'll be using a face mask. If the patient uses a suction machine, gather the machine and supplies. If your healthcare provider orders a one-way valve, you can add it to the resuscitation bag. While adding a one-way valve may make breath stacking more effective, the patient cannot exhale between inhalations. This can be uncomfortable and cause lung damage. For safety, in this home care video, we will not use a one-way valve. Put on the non-sterile gloves if you want to wear gloves. Gloves are not required for this treatment. Check to make sure suction supplies are prepared and ready for use, and that the machine is working properly. Starting at the resuscitation bag, assemble the extension tubing, adapter, and mask. If you are using a one-way valve, place it between the resuscitation bag and the extension tubing. If your child can communicate, figure out a signal that they can use if they need to stop the session. Put the mask over your child's mouth and nose. Make sure their chin is up and the mask forms a tight seal on their face. You can also use a mouthpiece and nose clip. Put the mouthpiece into your child's mouth and nose clip on their nose. The nose clip prevents air from leaking during the treatment. If your child has a trach tube, attach the adapter to the trach tube. If it's a cuffed trach tube, check the child's care plan. Typically, breath stacking requires that the cuff be inflated to maintain pressure in the airway. If your child is able, ask them to hold their breath as long as it is comfortable between each resuscitation bag breath. When they exhale, ask them to use the air to cough. Squeeze the resuscitation bag to give 3 to 5 big breaths in a row. This is one cycle. Most children receive 3 to 5 cycles twice a day. Monitor your child's color, heart rate, and comfort level during the cycles. If your child experiences dizziness, high heart rate, or chest pain, stop the therapy. If symptoms continue during the next cycle, contact the healthcare provider. Allow your child to rest and breathe normally for 30 seconds to 1 minute between cycles. Your child may cough or need to be suctioned during this time. Repeat the cycles followed by a rest period as prescribed by the healthcare provider. When the therapy session is complete, encourage your child to breathe deeply and cough if they can. Use the suction machine to clear secretions from the trach tube or back of the throat if needed. Clean the tubing and supplies regularly to prevent respiratory infection. Refer to instructions from your equipment provider, healthcare provider, and the product manufacturer to learn how.